My name is Rigoberto Rigo Reyes. I am the co-founder of Amigos Car Club, which was established back in 1977. One of the fundamental points as far as the relationship that we have with Chicano Park is the fact that many of us have been involved with different Chicano organizations, and particularly the Chicano Park Steering Committee. Amigos, for the past almost 40 years, has been the organizer and coordinator of the annual celebration of Chicano Park. We are the coordinators of the car show. The idea of the mural has been around for a number of years. We've done a number of projects, including some documentations in regards to the history of our car club. But for us, it was very important to establish and our presence there at Chicano Park, since we've been involved since the very beginning. So the idea of a mural was kind of like establishing ourselves and leaving a legacy behind. So for us, that's a very key element as far as why we did this particular project. We're very proud of it because not only are we representing our history, but also a history of the pioneers of low riding in San Diego County. The concept of the pillar basically is recognizing some important people within the Amigos Car Club, founding members, and also recognizing some fallen members from the Chicano Park Steering Committee who were very instrumental and had a very strong relationship with Amigos Car Club. The fundraising effort was a long time. It took us almost 2 years to fundraise. We did a number of activities, including events such as dances. Also, we reached out to different institutions and different organizations for their support, including NALAC, the National Association of Latino Arts and Culture, who came to our assistance and basically helped us fund part of the project. For us, that particular pillar was very important because to a great extent, it represents sort of like the welcoming to Chicano Park. It is very close to the freeway and therefore it could be seen from far away. So just having that opportunity to select that particular pillar was very important to us. Presenting the concept to the Chicano Park Steering Committee was a hard task. We needed to be sure that it covered all the criteria that they have as far as history, culture, and political. So we were lucky enough to present and also to be accepted in the first round. After introducing the concept of the pillar, it took almost a year for us to be approved. So it's important to people to realize that it's not an overnight thing. It's a long process. When we started the project, we were stopped by Caltrans, mainly because that particular pillar did not belong to the Chicano Park Steering Committee. It took a week of negotiations. Luckily, they worked with us as far as getting the proper permits, and we were able to continue, but it did stop the project for at least a week. We really appreciate the fact that they realized the importance of this pillar, and they decided to work with us and facilitate the process. Selecting the muralists was a difficult task, mainly because I have a very strong relationship with many of the artists from the area. But Sal Barajas was sort of like a natural selection because of the long relationship that we have with him and also his professionalism for us, that's very important. Sal tends to be very, very perfectionist, and we like that about him.
Mi nombre es Salvador Barajas, soy diseñador gráfico y director de arte. Tengo aproximadamente 50 años en este negocio. El primer mural en el que yo participé junto a un grupo de artistas del Centro Cultural de la Raza y de Barrio Logan fue el mural histórico en 1973. Después de eso, Ángeles de la Frontera me contrató en el 2017 para pintar un mural que se llamaba No Border Wall. El siguiente año me contrataron para pintar la Virgen de Guadalupe llevando un galón de agua. Rigoberto Reyes, uno de los fundadores de Amigos Car Club, se contactó conmigo y empezamos a trabajar en una idea que tenía él. Y la idea era hacer una especie de mapa en este mural. Ya el mural, el pilar se había seleccionado y empecé yo a hacer los diseños. Es una serie de pasos que se tiene que hacer para poder pintar un mural como eso. Uno de ellos es asegurarse de que el pilar está limpio, conseguir aseguranza, conseguir la aprobación del Parque Chicano y después conseguir el material que se necesita para pintarlo, brochas, pintura, etc. Lo primero que se hace para pintar un mural es pintar la pared blanca. Cuando menos ese es el proceso que yo utilizo. Después se hace un cuadriculado y se pasa la imagen a la pared. Normalmente se empieza de arriba para abajo para que cuando uno pinta, la pintura que cae de arriba no mancha lo que ya pintó uno abajo. Los andamios que se necesitan para pintar un mural como este son varios niveles y tiene que tener uno mucho cuidado de subir las escaleras y bajar las escaleras con cuidado para no caerse y crear un problema grave. El mural me tomó 3 meses. Trabajaba yo 6 días por semana, aproximadamente 8 horas diarias. Lo más difícil era mantener todo el tiempo en mente que el sol iba a obstaculizar el proceso. En este caso, yo acostumbro a usar pintura acrílica porque se seca rápidamente. El tipo de pincel o brochas que se usa para pintar un mural de este tamaño varía. Hay brochas de 3 pulgadas, brochas de 2, de 1 y pinceles pequeños para los detalles. Cuando uno empieza a pintar el mural, de nuevo, se empieza de arriba y no cambia uno, no se pasa uno de arriba abajo y así, sino que continúa pintando uno. No importa, si es detalle, pinta detalle, si es una masa grande de color, la pinta también. Una de las cosas que puede ser, que le puede dar satisfacción a un muralista es que la nueva generación se interese por continuar con ese arte. Para una persona que está en este ramo, es más que nada es satisfacer la necesidad del cliente, la idea, ejecutar la idea como ellos la querían. Y entonces ya uno queda satisfecho.
The description of the mural is very important to us. At the bottom of the mural, you see some magueyes and some nopales who truly represent our culture. We also wanted to include playas de Tijuana. Our cruise takes you throughout the border, and purposely we did not include a border in there if you look very closely, because us as lowriders and us as border people, we see this whole area as a region with no borders. Therefore, we decided not to include a border. The cruise takes you to some of the barrios, including San Isidro, Chula Vista, cruising to National City, which to us was a very important mecca of lowriding back in the 60s and 70s, until the closure of Highland Avenue. We included that because that was a part of our history. The cruise continues on through different barrios, ending in Chicano Park, symbolizing the importance of unity and brotherhood and carnalismo, if you will. As being part of this process, leaving this legacy behind, and recognizing the lowrider community as a whole, and amigos being in the forefront of this, is very important. Not only contributing to the history, but also being part of the history itself of Chicano Park. Commemorating 50 years of struggle, being recognized as a national landmark, and being part of this community is very, very, very important to us. We're very grateful to everybody that took part, particularly the Chicano Park Steering Committee, Via International, who was our sponsors, NALAC, who was also one of our sponsors, and many of the other groups and individuals that came in to help, stepped up to help us. It was a long process, two years of this hard work, but worth every minute of it.